Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding two takes on democracy written by Gautam Bhatia. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2 and paper 4. Plus this is important for political science, public administration and sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about the recent verdict of Supreme Court on section 123 subsection 3 of Representation of People's Act. Now, in order to understand this editorial, we need to understand three important aspects. The first aspect relates to about the social condition of India. And in this, we need to understand the concept of identity and reality. And then we need to understand the narrower and the broader meaning of word HIS in section 123 subsection 3 of Representation of People's Act, and the conclusion, the result, the outcome of the recent verdict. Now first of all, let us understand the social condition of India. Now India is divided among castes. India exhibits myriads of different types of identities in the shape of caste, identities in the shape of religion, identities in the shape of races, identities in the shape of different type of communities, identities in the shape of people speaking different languages. So generally, what is India? India is a kind of a cohesion of the fractured identities. India is one, but it is divided within on the basis of different identities, and these identities are based on caste, religion, race, communities and language. So India only at the face looks to be one, but in reality it is divided. Now are these divisions, are these fractures that are existing in Indian society, are they real or they are false or they are non-tangible? What is the tangibility and the intangibility about these identities? Now when we look at the caste or the various type of castes existing in India, now the groups, the people attached to these castes, they have a definitive type of material and non-material aspect attached with it. Now what is meant by this statement? That they have a material and non-material aspect attached with it. Now it means if you are belonging to a higher caste, you will get material and non-material aspects related to that caste. Now what is meant by it? It means that you will have easy access to respect, you will have easy access to recognition in the society, you will have easy mobility in the society, you will face less of social challenges in the society, you will face less of social boundations in the society, you will face less of restrictions in the society. You will have easy access to everything, But if you are belonging to a lower caste, in that case, your accessibility to the temples will be restricted. Your accessibility to the education will be restricted. Your accessibility to various types of professions will be dissuaded if not restricted. Your accessibility to the social life will be bounded, will be restricted. Now, if you are belonging to a particular caste, you have certain kind of limitations attached with it. You have certain kind of benefits attached with it. So, caste is something that provides an identity to an individual. And this identity is quite existential. This identity is quite tangible. ये है सोसाइटी में, आप इसको नकार नहीं सकते हैं. ये इंटेंजिबल नहीं है कि आपको कास्ट दिखाई नहीं देती है. डिस्पाइट इट बीइंग एन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट सब्जेक्ट, डिस्पाइट इट बीइंग एन एब्स्ट्रैक्ट कॉन्सेप्ट, स्टिल यू विल फील द टेंजिबिलिटी ऑफ कास्ट. यू विल स्टिल फील समथिंग कॉन्क्रीट अबाउट कास्ट. एंड सेम इज ऑल्सो ट्रू अबाउट रेस. इफ यू बिलोंगिंग टू अ पर्टिकुलर रेस, यू विल हैव सर्टन काइंड ऑफ ग्रेवियंसेज ऑफ people belonging to a particular race. Now again, you have language. Then you also have something about religion. There are minority religions. There are minority languages. People who don't speak language or a particular language in majority, they need the rights to be respected. The people who belong to minority religion, they need their rights to be respected. And the constitution was very much conscious about the rights of the minority religion, the rights of the minority people speaking language, rights of the races, the Anglo-Indians, etc., the rights of the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes. So you have various provisions in the constitutions whereby the race, caste, religion, language or community, they have been accorded sufficient position in the constitution. So the constitution has accorded various types of benefits on the basis of these parameters. And these parameters, they have also been the basis of how the democracy has been working till now. In democracy, the politician, the candidates, mobilizes the people on the basis of what discrimination has been done on the basis of caste, what discrimination has been done on the basis of language, how to protect the rights of a particular language, how to protect the right of a particular religion. So, isi tarah democracy work karta aaya hai. So, democracy is nothing but about making the voice of the people heard. Allowing the space to the people to speak up for their grievances, to speak up for their disenchantment, to speak up for what they really want, to stand up for their cause, to stand up for what are their rights. So this is democracy. So this is an ideal thing that I was talking about in love. But in reality, caste, race, language, religion or community is being used to create fissures in the society. It is being used to create division in the society. It is being used to create hierarchies in the society. It is being used to create fault lines in the society. So these things, they have created lot of disharmony in the society. This has created a kind of fundamentalism in the society. Such kind of fissures have acted as a big dissuadent in having access to the holistic development. Holistic development. When the people are mobilized on the basis of caste, what they are being offered is the development of a particular caste. If the people are mobilized on the basis of race, what they are being offered is the development on the basis of race. If the mobilization is done on the basis of language, what the people are being offered is the development on the basis of language. कि उसकी उनकी लैंग्वेज को प्रोटेक्ट किया जाएगा, उनकी जाति के जो अधिकार हैं उनको सम्मान दिया जाएगा, जो उनकी रेस के साथ एसोसिएटेड है, उनके रिलीजन के साथ एसोसिएटेड है, उसको प्रोटेक्ट किया जाएगा. कभी होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट की बात नहीं होती है जब आप मोबिलाइज ऑन द इन चीजों से करते हो. सो व्हाट एक्चुअली इज बीइंग प्रैक्टिस्ड इज अ स्यूडो डेमोक्रेसी, is a partial democracy. So basically, now let us come to the second, the narrow and the broader interpretation of the word has. Now when we read this section 1, 2, 3 and subsection 3, there is a word his. His is attached to the person who has been mobilizing people's opinion. Earlier his was believed to be the religion of the person who is fighting the elections. Agar main election fight kar raha hun, to main logon ko ye nahi bata sakta tha pehle कि मैं हिंदू हूं या मेरे जो मेरा ओपोनेंट है वो हिंदू नहीं है या वो मुस्लिम है या वो सिख है या वो किसी और धर्म को बिलोंग करता है, आप उसके हिसाब से वोट कीजिए. दिस वाज समथिंग दैट वाज नॉट अलाउड. अगर मैं ऐसे करता तो आई वाज लायबल फॉर प्रोसिक्यूशन, आई वाज लायबल फॉर करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस, रिसोर्टिंग टू करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस. सो दिस इज द कीवर्ड, करप्ट प्रैक्टिसेस. ऑफ लेट अभी जो रीसेंट वर्डिक्ट आया है उसने इस हिज की डेफिनेशन को चेंज कर दिया है. डेफिनेशन को चेंज करके क्या कहा कि मैं खुद भी नहीं बता सकता कि मैं किस धर्म का बिलोंग, किस धर्म को बिलोंग करता हूं, और मैं ये भी नहीं बता सकता लोगों को कि आप किस हिसाब से वोट कीजिए. आप इस धर्म को प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए वोट कीजिए, आप इस कास्ट को प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए वोट कीजिए, आप इस रेस को प्रोटेक्ट करने के लिए वोट कीजिए या लैंग्वेज को प्रोटेक्ट. मैं इन चीजों को बता के लोगों से वोट्स नहीं मांग सकता. तो ये सारा कुछ इनवैलिड कर दिया है सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने. इफ आई विल बी मोबिलाइजिंग पीपल ऑन द प्रोमिसेस ऑफ डूइंग वेलफेयर ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर कास्ट और ऑफ डूइंग वेलफेयर ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर रिलीजन और लैंग्वेज और कम्युनिटी और रेस, इन दैट केस इवन इफ आई विल इफ आई एंड अप विनिंग द इलेक्शन, it will be declared as invalid as per section 123 subsection 3 of the Representation of the People's Act. So now this word his has been given broader meaning. So this is the recent verdict, this is the recent gist of the verdict. Now the conclusion result of what is the outcome of this verdict, outcome would be like the politicians no longer will be able to mobilize people on the basis of these things. But it is also very true that these things are the realities existing in India. अगर आप इन पॉइंट्स के ऊपर मोबिलाइज नहीं कर पाओगे तो किन के ऊपर आप लोगों का व्यू मोबिलाइज करोगे? आपकी डेमोक्रेसी जिस हिसाब से आप प्रैक्टिस करोगे वो बहुत अच्छी डेमोक्रेसी नहीं होगी. Now the question that can be analyzed, critically analyze the outcome of the recent verdict of Supreme Court on section 123 subsection 3. Now another question could be like, what are the positives and the negatives of this verdict? So this was all for the day. Now if you want to read more on this, you can read Brainy Map on the same on brainyias.com, and you can also watch other current affair lectures on brainyias.com. And if you want to buy a package of the entire civil services preparation, contact us on 84594000. Now if you want more information on the classes that we are offering, please visit brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice night.